Okay, we are sitting outside on the porch enjoying breakfast. Angel, how was your breakfast?
Pretty good. I'm just stirring my hot chocolate. Kind of on the hot side, okay?
Hot chocolate's on the hot side. What do you know? So anyway, so we're outside of our hotel eating breakfast. We went across the street. We got some super healthy McDonald's over there. Which actually wasn't bad, you know, if you get oatmeal and such. So
this is Nick's iPhone, okay? Guys.
Yeah, it's okay. You don't need to.
Anything?
All right. So, what, Dennis? So, you want to tell us the secret? What is our destination of the day, Mr. Pancake?
Yeah.
Over here. Where are we going?
Fort Ticonderoga.
Fort Ticonderoga.
Yeah. Right way to say it is Fort Ticonderoga.
Yeah. Is that the right way?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, all right, we're checking out, got our stuff, walking out. Andrew, get the door. Gotta load stuff to the car and get out of here.
So I just want to quickly clarify one thing, that to keep myself entertained in the car, just bring electronic devices. You're pretty much always going to be bored, or read a book. There are some entertainment tips.
Those are wonderful entertainment tips that work for kids and parents. So yes, bring books and I don't know. I just hope they're gonna work. All right, Andrea, open the trunk.
You told me before you were so
sure. I told you not to open it when I told you not to open it.
Oh, you got the flashlight.
Yes, don't.
Dad brought the super powerful flashlight.
Yay, we are ready to. We're all loaded in the car. You guys doing something?
This car is full of butts. Yeah, there are four butts in here.
Yeah, it's full.
Well,
of
okay. Thanks for counting, Andrew.
And it's also full of stuff back there. You can even see the extent of some of the stuff.
Oh yeah, like various tripods sticking out. Jesus, who packed all that camera stuff?
You okay. Did.
Yay, we're at Fort Ticonderoga. Dennis, are you happy?
Yeah!
You got a map?
Yeah.
You got a musket?
No.
Good, let's keep it that way. Dennis wants to get a musket from the souvenir shop. He wanted it for like 2 years. But,
I've been wanting it for more than two years?
I don't know if we're gonna... Mr. Skeleton over here. All right. So our plan is to go on a tour and visit a souvenir shop, and Dennis wants a musket and he promises to behave perfectly. So I don't know if that's gonna happen. We are hoping to see demonstration of rifles. Please enter. And this is what they wanted in here.
I don't. The black thing actually moved.
Is that what you wanted, Dennis?
Yeah, one of these.
What are you gonna do with it?
I think I once saw one of these on Amazon, but I don't know.
Right. Alright, so we'll get you a little pink one over here, right?
No!
And they said these are special because it's a holiday weekend, but the regular ones are here.
Okay, so 11 o'clock?
11 o'clock and 2 o'clock.
Okay. Look at the view. Whoa, hang on. Look at the lake we got over here. This is so awesome. With all the like boats and stuff.
See
yes.
The flag? This is where we're going.
Oh.
The mountain.
So, yeah, this is where we want to go later. That's the flag. So, there is like a trail that we can drive, not necessarily hike, right? This is for driving.
Unfortunately, they have like tours at 4 o'clock every day, and we're not gonna make it.
Oh. Right.
This is why I wanted to be here yesterday. I wanted to.
But that's okay. We can drive up that mountain, and we can get the nice view. Maybe we can fly drone over there. Shh! Don't tell anybody. Okay, let's go see a demonstration. Oh, Andrew, you wanted to say something.
I wanted to say that monopods, tripods, and drones aren't allowed. So Dad was able to get away with by using one of these bendy tripods.
Right, I got my back to basics, back to my bendy selfie stick. And Dennis already went away exploring all the guns and stuff. The main attraction is the demonstration of muskets and cannons, and they're gonna shoot. They're not gonna shoot these cannons. They have a special one. Apparently, these are like not safe to shoot. So they have the one that is safe to shoot. They're not gonna actually put a charge in it, but they're gonna do the whole thing, and we can check it out. So that is the first thing we're gonna do on this tour: is see all the people dressed up and do all this marching and everything.
Your post march.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to Fort Ticonderoga.
Do come right on up so you can see the intricate workings of these firelocks. And in the jaws of that cock there, we have that sharpened or napped piece of flint. In front of that, we have this L-shaped piece here called the hammer. The hammer's made out of iron, but has a face of steel welded to the front of it so that when you bring the cock to its full cock position, resting a bunch of tension on a mainspring coiled up inside the lock, held in check only by the trigger, and you pull the trigger, the flint flies forward into the battery, creating a shower of sparks. Now those sparks are going to rain down into this sugar spoon looking piece here called the pan. You gotta kneel down, then you gotta get back up every time you load your weapon. This is cumbersome. And we know that as early as April 19th at the battles of Lexington and Concord, we know they've eliminated that front rank man and gone just to this simple two rank system. Now what's great about this two rank deep system is that when the rear rank goes to present their weapon, they clear the front rank at a nice safe margin. That is to say, though, that they're at a half arm distance away from one another. Suddenly you increase that to a step away and things don't look so good anymore. So these men must stay this close together to safely fire their weapons. This so that they can then
have your cartridge.
Bringing the weapon to their breast, they grab a cartridge out of their cartridge box, tear it open with their teeth, holding it under their chin for safety's sake. They then wait for the odor to
hit,
pouring that priming charge into the pan. They then
shut pan,
shutting the pan over the powder, bringing the weapon across their body, holding the cartridge next to the barrel so that they can then
charge with cartridge,
pouring that powder, the whole cartridge with the projectiles down the barrel, starting their ramrods out to
withdraw your revers.
Drawing that rammer out together, starting it into the muzzle to then
ram down cartridge,
ramming everything home to the breech of the gun, returning that rammer, except for the last few inches, they then get the order to
turn your rammer.
One, two.
coming back up to the position of recover. Now that these soldiers are loaded, they then will get the order to...
Show me your pilot!
One, two.
And just as we loaded these weapons, a few things have to happen to have these men safely fire them together. To start the firing process, these soldiers will be ordered to...
Make ready!
They snap their weapons off their hips, throwing it to the left of their face. They then get the order to...
Freeze it!
And at this point, these men will take careful aim. Make no mistake, these men are trained to take aim at a specific target. They then wait quietly and patiently for the order to...
Fire!
And just like that, all the weapons go off together. Now, these men train daily in this exercise by the numbers.
But where'd he go?
But, of course, in the heat of battle, they can just get the simple order to... Still working together without bumping into one another, loading their weapons at their own speed, but working still together. Notice they cast their weapons across their bodies all together. Now, when that Continental Army arrives here at Ticonderoga, and these Pennsylvanian soldiers go up to the heights of Carrion, they are ordered to defend that ground. Now, this two-rank system works well to mass firepower together in an open field. But if we're gonna be here at Ticonderoga waiting on the British to advance and we have time, what can this army do in preparation as they wait? For those that can fit a bayonet, they can have these bayonets attached to ward off the enemy. John Lacey, a captain in the 4th Pennsylvania Battalion, noted that on October 28th, when the British Army advanced, and the men fell out to the lines, he noticed.
Section! First section! Make ready! Freeze it! Fire! First section! Come in! Left!
And like this, the army can fire
second
down
section.
That line, keeping weapons loaded. So that no section of that line could be overrun by an advancing British army. Imagine sections and companies down the line all doing...
Second section, run in, load!
Keeping these weapons loaded.
First section, over your...
During the year of 1776, as these Pennsylvanian soldiers dig in, they will practice in
first section,
this
ready.
Firing by platoon exercise.
Freeze it! Fire!
Second section, first section, half cup fuel, pilot.
Think so bad. Think so bad.
Gunpowder.
Pilot, fire!
You allow us to continue our mission, preserving this historic place, as well as enabling us to continue and to foster a discussion about our nation's history and its impact on current and future generations. So for that, I thank you all for being here, and I thank you for watching the musket demonstration. Thank you very much. Myself and some of my fellow soldiers will stick around for any questions if you have them.
I think I broke my camera. All right, so it's confirmed I broke my camera. You hear how echoey everything is? I dropped the camera on the side and the microphone, where the microphone goes in, the little jack on the side, I hit that, it seems like. And so something damaged internally, so now it's like all crackling and stuff. I guess we're gonna have to go with the internal mic. Hopefully it's gonna sound okay. There's Andrew over here.
You then.
So all these buildings behind me, like all these, they are museums. They have sleeping quarters. They demonstrate like how they make clothes, how to do different things. So you can walk into all these doors and you could see, you can get like explanation and demonstration of something that they do. So all these people are dressed up and they like in character, they doing something. I hope this wind isn't terrible. Yeah, all these people are in character, and between demonstrations, they're actually, well, demonstrating how people used to live at that time, and they talk about, you know, what's going on. So it's really cool, actually, to see. Walked to this place called King's Garden. It's right next to the fort, and I guess it's a garden, and I don't know why it's called King's Garden, but it's really nice and pretty. We're just gonna check out some flowers, hang out here, and I believe we want to go back to the fort for a cannon demonstration and then drive up on the mountain. So just gonna hang out here for a little bit, see like all the pretty flowers, and then back to the fort. Said they took this boat out to a sea trials and it failed, and clearly we know why, but what they said is this boat's been sitting out so long due to COVID that it all dried up and shrunk. It's supposed to be more like moist, so they have to restuff it with this stuff and then take it out in the water again, let all the wood like swell up, and then all the gaps are gonna, you know, compress, and it's like a barrel, you know, you get it wet. So yeah, it's pretty cool. They're building boats over here. Usually they're like really far away and you can't see anything. Here is one that's like super close. Let's get some zoomage going here. Where is
it? Really close to them. That's cool.
Look at that osprey, just I don't know that, what
that's an adult, right? That's not, well, a baby.
I figured, yeah, there should be some babies there. Are those two? Is no, that's not moving. Maybe that looked like a baby.
Oh, this is cool, right?
No, in the nature, ospreys build their own platforms.
Oh, is that so?
Yeah, they have to chop down a tree, put it like in the ground, and then get some wooden boards from Home Depot and build a platform, and then take some branches and put them on top. Yeah, that's how it works in nature. I think someone's moving in there. They're babies. They're definitely babies in there.
Yeah, you can see them.
Yep, there are babies in there.
Yeah, that's cool. Look at that.
You guys see there are two babies in there?
I can't even see the osprey.
Okay.
There are two babies.
You cannot even see osprey? And now we found some cows, bulls, and kids are trying to, you know, like communicate with them. How are you doing that? What are you doing, Dennis? That's how you communicate with them?
Yeah, no, it's failing.
It's failing? They just want to eat hay and not pay attention to us.
There we go.
Can I pet you? Are you okay? Ooh. Touch the horns. Careful. So it doesn't pinch the horns between, doesn't pinch your hand between horn and a fence. You can touch the horns. Carefuling.
Yeah. Oh.
It's got some.
Who wants a souvenir?
Me.
You have one, Andrew. This is okay. An osprey feather.
That's an osprey feather?
Yep.
We're touching horns over here.
This is cool. Let me take a picture of you guys. Hey, you guys.
Careful, don't hit the fence. So we made it back to the car. We walked around the whole fort. So dark. We walked around the whole fort, King's Gardens, make a big loop, came back. Everyone's like super tired because of the sun. We're probably just gonna try to have some lunch and then head up on that mountain we talked about. I see cannons. Well, I guess it's a good idea to have cannons to defend the mountain. Ooh. Ooh. What are you doing, Andrew?
Wow,
look at the view. How do you like the view, Mom? What?
That's beautiful.
All right.
Was it worth it for you to come here?
Well, I don't know. Where is our fort? Where is the fort that we were in? Like over there somewhere?
Yeah, you can see it.
I can't. Let's go. Let's go up on the thing here and see if we can spot the fort we were in. All right. Hey, Dennis, how's the view? There's the fort. There, that's where we were. All right, so that's the fort we were in just earlier. So we drove from there up the mountain to here, and now we're up right here. You having fun, Dennis?
Yeah.
Do you like the mountain now?
Yeah, but I want to point out that there are a pair of cannons over there.
Yeah, there are cannons right over there. We noticed them as soon as we got in. Those are the cannons. What are they doing? They defending the mountain?
Yes.
No, no, no. Okay, can you not do that? Okay. Yeah. Are there any cool views on the other side? Let's check it out. So this is looking really awesome here. And all the mountains in the distance. Yeah. That's a really good view over here. And you got people like on the boats hanging out by the fort. It's really nice. Yep. What do you think of the mountain, Andrew?
Yeah, that's cool.
Cool view?
Yeah, pretty good. But then I do have questions for you about the...
All right, we got a few selfies over here. We next gonna head to our hotel. I got a video like that. There you go. Look at you looking down at things. Okay, our car is like right down there. So now
it looks like a river.
Now we need to what's the name of the lake? This is Champlain. Okay, yeah. That's what I thought. We need to get to Golden Arrow Hotel and meet up with the rest of the party. Ow, flies. Like a giant fly landed on me. Okay, let's drive there. All right, Dennis is kayaking here. As you can tell, we've checked into our hotel and we're enjoying water sports. The rest of our party Alex and Natasha over here. Okay, Dennis, don't crash, don't crash. Don't crash. Oh, you crashed. Why are you crashing into things?
I don't know.
All right. Okay, learn to control it. Go have fun. Yeah, so the deal is... Whoa, don't spray me. What are you doing?
I'm careful.
Are you careful?
Your spray lower left foot away from your phone even.
Okay. All right, that's... That right there is Melissa.
I'm not doing anything inappropriate.
What are you? Hey, don't spray people. Wait.
That's for what I...
Hang on. Okay, so hang on. Alex, Natasha, we got Melissa over here. Dennis is already went kayaking. Right there. Oh, he's getting some help.
He's got a friend.
You've got a friend in me.
Yep. And my mom and Tanya are all the way over there. My dad went to get some sleep. Andrew's walking around. How'd you do, Dennis? Okay, get the oar and the life jacket and put them back where they belong. You getting control over your kayak? You getting what? Ну, как у вас там? How you guys doing? How you guys doing?
We're doing good.
It's a video now.
Swimmingly, you might say.
Swimmingly?
Swimmingly.
Is the word that you choose to describe your swimming in kayak? Hey, hey.
Oh,
you look cool. Okay. But don't crash into people. What are you doing? All right. Dennis, what are you doing?
Keeping myself dry.
You hiding from the rain?
Yeah.
Dennis is hiding himself from the rain under a tree.
Stop here and wait. No, this is a precious. I hope you're filming this.
Yeah, I'm filming. Okay. Are you planning on falling?
Yeah.
I'm just asking.
About it.
Why should I be filming? Wow! Look at the view. Forget Tanya. Look at the view. Hang on, the view. Look at the view. Wow.
That was the point. Climb higher. We're not there yet.
Yeah, let me take
okay.
A video.
Well, we're almost there. Somebody's been saying it for the last hour.
Okay.
So we're on top of the mountain and we can't see anything and it's raining. It is beautiful, like you see those mountains there. Something to do with the highest in New York.
Second highest peak in New York.
It was what?
Second highest peak in New York.
Oh, yeah, okay, yeah. We have the guide behind us, but I wasn't paying attention. He was explaining. It's actually weird.
The shortest one is in front of it.
Right. It's actually weird. There's like a person posted on top of the hiking trail that helps people explain stuff. So.
Not a geologist.
All right. And we're also like with umbrellas on top of the mountain. So I hope we're not going to have like a, you know, cartoon style accent with the lightning going. You know, that would be highly unpleasant.
Maybe it'll just be a tree in front of us and it'll be a nice show.
Oh yeah, hopefully that. Ну, плывешь? Как плывется?
Perfect.
Вода теплая?
Yep, very good.
Okay. Ну, вон там Таня плывет. Таня к середине озера поплыла. Ты к середине озера не плывешь?
Нет. Я себя чувствую неуютно, когда я не чувствую дна.
Окей. Okay. Таня about to crash. She did crash. Let's see if she's gonna fall in the water. You got it? Okay, jump with both feet on. Oh, she made it back.
Thank you.